So it looks like we're about to have a game here, folks. Quick predictions here. Couch one.
I'm going to ride EG.
EG all the way.
EG all the way. Couch two.
Well.
Believe I'm going with Winter. I believe in Winter. Don't let me down yet.
Okay.
Uncertainty.
I just like EG. I think EG's dynamic is just much more solid.
All right, fair enough. Game's underway. We'll send it over now to our casters. It's going to be OD and Draskal. Have some fun.
Hey, Dakota, we're ready to get ourselves going with the final game of this series. And what an eventful series it has been so far, Andy. We've had some great stuff going on. Looking at the drafts for this game, I don't think we can expect anything less. It's going to be action on top of action with a little bit more action.
Can't wait. I'm really curious to see how the Midge Kira works out. I've heard of it before, but I haven't actually seen it personally, so I'm curious to see how complexity you're going to play around this. Obviously, it increases the tempo of your team in the sense that you're going to be pushing towers very early. Getting tier 1s down with the Jakiro, especially in a core capacity, is going to be very easy. It's kind of similar to Pugna in a way, except instead of going in and jousting with the Nether Blast, you're going to be using the Liquid Fire to just chip things down, and plus he functions very well in a 5-man push scenario when you have the Beastmaster Inner Aura, or Inner Beast as well. So Karn's gonna spawn, both teams gonna split up here. Complexity get top, EG get bottom. And I think that EG's teamfight is probably a little bit stronger if the sphere is good. If the sphere isn't good, then probably still favor Complexity. Earth Spirit's like amazing teamfighter if you can land a good Earth Smash and Silence, but yeah, it should be a close game.
I'm interested to see how the lanes pan out. Obviously, Fear on his Mirana is gonna be roaming around the map. It's not the Arteezy Mirana that some of us may have dreamed about. It's just going to be the standard roaming Fear. I'll see how impactful he can be as he makes a journey around the lanes across the map. At the same time, Z-Freak, kind of a similar hero in capacity of what the Mirana's going to be doing at the area stages. It's just going to be interesting to see who has the bigger impact across the map.
I think it's quite a bit harder for Mirana to have the same impact. We're going to see the universe getting harassed here pretty heavily. Going to walk it off. The biggest difference between heroes like Earth Spirit and Mirana is that Earth Spirit is more reliable as some kind of help, and that's why they were kind of joking on the couch that the heroes aren't really directly comparable, because I think Earth Spirit's just a little bit easier to use, and I think in a general sense he can offer way more to a team. But if you land a Mirana arrow, it should be a kill.
You wondered how the mid lane Jakiro work out.
He got arrowed, so.
Oh yeah.
Arrow is death. That's pretty much how it works.
Yeah. Fear on point there with the aim. Of course, they'll be very happy with that one. Somehow now getting the space to continue to break away here on the Luna 7 for 4. As the Harifa 0 on the Jakiro. And top lane at the moment, a bit of action by the looks of it. Moving forward onto PPDs to Freak, just trading the slaps. He's going to be fine. Edson back off. Yeah, I mean, let's talk about the Jakiro mid. I mean, what do you feel Complexity have the need? Why do you feel that this is the game that they bring that out?
I think that it's a hero that offers a very unique style of play. Not many mid heroes with no items can just go push, right? Like, if you have level 7, level 4 Liquid Fire allows you to kill a tower, no questions asked. Like, the amount of damage that it does, the attack speed slow, any lineup that you put together is automatically like a push lineup. He has incredible stats. At 2.8 in game, 2.3 strength gain. His laning phase itself is strong because he has a nuke pretty much that costs no mana in the form of Liquid Fire. Dual Breath is good wave clear and a very long duration slow. And he also has a disable, plus he just got 7 base damage in a recent patch. So I think that this hero could have seen a little bit more mid, and it's actually something that's extremely old school on top of it.
See that Fear is really looking for the potential to get an arrow in the mid lane. Hiding there in between the tier 1s and the tier 2s, ready to come in from behind. They can, if he feels he can get the angle.
This is a very hard angle to dodge as well.
Being incredibly patient here, Fear. He really wants to try and land it again. He knows if he hits the arrow, that's going to be a dead Jakiro. There's not really anything that Complexity can do in terms of turning up into lane to save him. The lineup and at this period of the game. Bottom lane Universe's struggling a little bit more at this game in terms of finding the farm that we've seen Universe get in the earlier 3 minutes of the first two games. He's got 6 CS at this point, but the levels are great here, and that's kind of what really matters here for the Void.
Yeah, they can't kill him. Like, Morphling does pretty much all burst damage. Handskin can kind of chip him down with Arctic Burn, but if you want to get the kill, you need to use Splinter Blast as well. And Limp's gonna spot out Fear here in the woods. Look at how much damage that does. That was one Liquid Fire, and a dual breath, pretty much. And it did that much damage.
Snow the lane, going in here with the cast, they'll catch the Chaos Spirit out. G. So there's another kill here in the laning stage. At the moment, let's see, it certainly feels like the lane's really favoring the side. Arrow coming through mid, oh, it's going to be blocked by the creep wave though. They won't find the connection. Z3 now coming in and look at the snow off onto Fear, he's got to leave in literally a second. So it will be fine, just gets up to the high ground. Samael does pick up Limp at the same time. There's a rotation from the Winter Wyvern. Slows catching out Samael, it pops the Fairy Fire and Complexity won't quite be able to get that. A nice light strike from the Lina, just thrown down onto Zifreak so nothing can follow through. Top lane, up TZ, moving in with the Storm Hammer. The cast flying in as well. Now, Barnes under the tower here with the War Cry. They're looking for Swindles. Will they be able to get it? Yes, they will. They're taking him down. Hans can TPing in. Not really got anything to throw out to catch out. Oh, Toy Valwar. AC stuck in the river now. Zifreak is there. They got the burst to bring him. Look at the slow out. The body block, Z-Freak's like, you shall not pass. And RTZ says, I'll turn around and hit the dragon. They don't care, they'll take him down. RTZ caught out there in the river.
Nice that they were able to get themselves on the board. The first couple of exchanges have been heavily favoring EG. Ever since that first blood stemming from an arrow coming in from Fear, it just feels like the laning phase is important. EG always managed to perform in this matchup. And I'd always said it, at least in the last game, if it's just a game that's based around the laning stage, I would pretty much always favor EG. Although I do think that the Complexity have a really solid plan, and I think their 5-manning potential puts them about on par with what EG would do in a 5 versus 5 situation, assuming the draft isn't heavily favored towards one side when it comes to team fight. This time around, I don't really think that that's the case. Talked about, it's pretty much, does the Sphere land? If the Sphere is really good, then EG probably walk away with it. If not, I think Complexity have a good shot. But as it stands right now, it seems like top lane...
Swindles again, he's gonna pop there. Look, Lester down bottom. Samael was hanging around, he wanted to use the Laguna Blade to try and go onto chest, and the Z-Freak and Hans can come in, they catch him out of the jungle. Universe is about to pull the Chrono, but Samael's gonna get taken down! Chessie was able to jump through, and Hans can getting the final touch. Mount Fury and Universe have to be a little bit careful on this one. They'll start to retreat, and it looks like it will just be Samael going down, but Samael, he spent a good 30 seconds sitting there at the bottom lane trying to go in on Chessie. Complexity, they saw that he was off the map, they made the movement down there, ready for EG, and they come out on top.
That was a really unfortunate Chronosphere as well. He probably wasn't expecting the waveform to be coming out at that particular point in time, because he dropped it in a way that makes me think that he just wanted it to be defensive, and he used it to just walk it off, but fortunately for him, it ends up just being a death for his mid player. It's not going to put him in terrible of a spot. Considering the circumstances, he is a little bit behind on what Limp has right now, but experience-wise, he's doing okay.
Mid lane somehow. He's gonna maintain his position here for now. Still has that Laguna, of course, so if anyone comes too close, try and go for some action. The question is, what is the build here from the mid Jakiro? Will we just see the Yules coming out first for them?
I think Yules is really nice when you're actually leveling Ice Path, but this is the type of build that I feel is going to be more centered around going for push. So I wouldn't be surprised to see something like Mech, for example. I think that's a really strong thing. You could also go Veil, since you have Earth Spirit on your team, and you have a good amount of magic damage too. I mean, your Morphling is eventually going to pick up Evilade, but there are a lot of choices. And since we don't really see it that much, to be honest, it's going to be one of those things where you see it, and most of the time it's going to be team-oriented. I think with this type of draft, they are looking to push. So I would lean definitely towards the mech or perhaps the Veil.
5-2 at the moment on the scoreboard. Totting net worth over on the side of EG. Are beginning to slowly advance, and RTZ, he's the man at the top. Getting a lot of space top lane. Double 8 at this point. Lifesteal in the shreds. He's going to feel very comfortable in this lane. And looking at Complexity's lineup, they're going to need to throw a fair few heroes up there if they want to try and ever take down Artur on the spin.
It's going to take a pretty heavy commitment. I mean, do you really want to go for the hero who's maxing out Warcry? He's already got armor with that ability, and their magic damage burst isn't tremendous by any stretch. They're going to need almost everyone actually take him down, and I don't really think they want to commit that many resources. Their game plan doesn't necessarily have to involve killing Sven. It can just be as simple as walking up and killing towers. Like, Limp is level 7, he's got max level Liquid Fire. At this stage in the game, Complexity's lineup can already take every single tier 1 off the map. Just what Jakiro lets you do. Now, if they're going to go for it that fast, that's a completely different sort.
RCBZ with the storm wall, and then straight there into the arrow. Looking for Zifreen. The Ruinar Tor might actually, yeah, it's going to be enough to allow Zifreen to get himself out. Now Complexity, they're the ones looking to turn this around. Chessie's coming on the Morphling. Great Rorqual Swindles there, saving the Earth Spirit. And RTZ is actually going to be the one going down. Lynn comes in, the magical damage is too much. They don't give a damn about the Warcry there. And just great reaction there for Complexity.
Man, I thought for a second he was just going to let the Earth Spirit die. Like, he was walking forward as if he wanted to roar the backline hero, but gets it out just in time. Allows a nice little bit of turn there. We were just talking about how difficult it is to kill the Sven. If you bait him into a bad engagement, that's a really good way of killing somebody without having to commit a lot of resources to it. And since EG were the initiators, it was quite easy to get Artur in a position where they could kill without the maximum amount of heroes necessary. But smoke here from EG. They're looking for potentially a Sphere on middle lane. They do have Laguna still.
The Death Ward as well from PPD. If Universe can find an opening, find a couple of heroes, maybe even three. There's three at the moment hanging around the mid lane for the side of Complexity. So if they come too close, Universe desperately hanging on the side. Wants someone to come forward. Who's it going to be? Limp? They know that they're playing very, very carefully. Looks to be that they're not going to get anything. Complexity, they're not going to come forward. EG realize that they can't waste too much time just waiting for something to happen mid, and they'll head off to do other things around the map. Universe will start to stack up the Ancients there as well.
Getting full use of the time when you're on the map. You have a Sven on your team who's maxing cleave. There's no reason not to try to get some attacks going. They do have a warded though.
Ah, yeah, it's blocked.
So,
yeah.
It's a Complexity where definitely feeling that that could be a possibility. And looks like Sumail is making his way towards the Ghouls. As soon as that's done, probably going to see some Cavill plays coming out. But the rotation from Complexity with a level 4 Liquid Fire, having red stuff on Lim. Tower just doesn't really do anything with Liquid Fire on it. That's probably the main reason. It's not even so much about the damage, even though it is good. The attack speed slow is what makes it so ridiculous. It's 50 attack speed that you lose as soon as one application of it is applied to the tower. So its ability to protect dives and also the ability for it to deep push just become awful. Makes Chikiro really nice if you want to have a very quick way of taking map control.
And so about map control is this the tier 1 for tier 1 trade. EG are able to take themselves down that top one in return. So overall, the net worth difference is only 2k at this point of the game. Much, still a close one. Like, seeing if they can eye up something on the bottom lane. Both teams really, yeah, just have the two supports hang around the mid lane, the safe lane, and alternate. But at this point, both teams are playing very safely, and we're not seeing that many people getting caught out of position.
Yeah, it's kind of because of the nature of the lineups, though. I think EG are actually more ultimate based than Complexity at this stage. It's like we keep talking about, Chikiro can just walk up the towers and slow siege. If you have Beastmaster around, he has 2 points and an Inner Beast. You get a creep wave, couple of boars, a liquid fire, the tower is dead. Like, you don't require ultimates to do stuff like that, but EG, they have Chronosphere, Laguna. Run all these off cooldown now too, because we're finally got level 6. And Witch Doctor Death Ward. So their team is much more 5 versus 5, you know, let's go fight, let's land a good sphere and take the team fight, then push after. Where Complexities doesn't really need to rely on those cooldowns quite as much.
Not easy now. 1300 on top of the helm tricks. What kind of build do you think we'll go for here on the Sven?
I assume he's just gonna go for the standard, just get SMY. Sphere bottom.
For Handsken, some else there with the Laguna, they will bring down Handsken now, Chessie. Coming across, but the Moonlight Shadow will be enough to get EG out of there by the looks of it. Can't react to that one, so it's cost a couple of ults, but I guess EG never kill under their belt.
Fine. I mean, they were sitting in the area for quite a while. If you're not getting a kill because you're waiting for somebody who has a higher like kill priority, like Chessie or Limp, for example, if you're sitting there for too long, you kind of have to throw out an ability to make it worth your time. Otherwise, you just back off and nothing is really accomplished. But after seeing Spear used, they're just going to go ahead and push the tower. Should be quite easy.
I should find at least the tier 1. I'll be interested if they stick around for more, as you said, with the ults. Three of them down at the moment for EG. Complexity might want to use this to push for more. Same time, Martizzi getting a bit of the split going on the top lane. He'll start hammering down onto the tier 2. And what did he pick up there? Was it the Blink Dagger in the... No, it was the Yasha first here for our tour. So keep on that path game. Our path will catch our PBD way forward from Chessie. Pick up the Witch Doctor on the bottom. And that might give the space bar looks a bit for the side of Complexity to take down at tier 2. RTZ still standing strong here on the top. Trying to make some kind of reaction come out of Complexity, and it will come through the form of Limp. Complexity, they were able to find the tier 2 on the bottom lane and certainly get the objectives that their lineup requires.
It just goes to show how easy it is. Like, they see one teamfight ultimate used, and they're like, oh, well, we're going to go ahead and just push two towers because we got Jakiro. That's just a strength that it offers you. Now, granted, a support Jakiro might not be level 9 by now, but a support Jakiro can also offer you something a little bit similar. Since if you have a safe laner who likes to rotate around, take game 2 when Arturo was playing Clanks, decided to rotate safe lane and kill the Death Prophet. If you have a Jakiro support in that game, you can just soak EXP, but STP there gets himself out of harm's way. And Z-Freak 6-2, so they got... Yeah, the teamfight ultimate's available on the side of Complexity now as well.
RTZ back to safety and back to the Ancients. More gold into the pocket of the big map. So EG now with a smoke. Some mail and PPD. Death Ward and Laguna available. We saw them use Laguna at least to blow up Hanscan before, and Hanscan has been smart. TP's away. PPD and some mail unlikely to find anything with this smoke here. At least they might be able to try and get that tier 1 bottom. But anything is going to be a trade. It's Complexity, they've got their eyes on the tier 1 top. They should be able to take this one. We've already seen the pushing pair of Limp on his Jakiro. EG, even with the ultimate sub, they're just not in a position to defend this. Complexity, should they try and go for more here, or will they respond to the push mid?
No, they're going. The thing is, if they get to base, and EG base, EG are the ones who have back. Because Complexity has a better push. And also fighting into Chronosphere, fighting into Moonlight Shadow is probably something that with a Morphling on your team, only has a Yasha, doesn't seem like too attractive a choice right now. I think they'll be more than content to just push this.
It's going to be a tier 1 for tier 2 trade. Another very favorable trade here for the side of Complexity. They may lose the tier 1 bottom as well. You're trying to work on that, but Complexity, they want to go full in. Now, they're obviously going to be aware that they are fighting into all the ultimates of EG here. So EG, they're going to have a good chance of accumulating a defense, fighting into this high ground advance from Complexity. And there we go, Universe jumps in, gets the corner off onto Limp and Swindles. They'll drop the Death Ward down with a cold embrace. The physical damage doing nothing here to the Jakiro. Death Ward shot, now it's a free roll again. The roar onto Universe, the magnetite as well. Onto three heroes, Ice Park gets laid down onto three. But EG, healing up nicely thanks to Voodoo Restoration, PvD ticking down low. But he will survive. No one dying on EG, but at the same time, unable to even kind of just break their health bars and Complexity as they walk out with full health, and no one gets punished.
Yeah, and EG are going to be feeling not so hot about that. They took quite a bit of damage on their tier 3. Like, that was only 2 liquid fires, I think, and the Creeps just beat it down to almost half health. They drop their ultimates, they get no kills from it. That is not a good thing. Like, they need to be able to pressure, they need to try to find some kind of picks before Complexity are able to, like, regain their bearings, push again. Because if they keep getting to the base like that, eventually that tier 3 is going to be down. Then your racks are exposed, those eventually fall, and then you have a real big problem on your hands. So I would like to see EG playing a little bit more proactive, try to get out on the map, make sure that Complexity aren't going to be the ones getting the tier 3s first, and just try to control the tempo themselves. Like, don't let Complexity dictate the pace of the game.
Us? Self back there. Lads, close to having that one done. Aetherlens now finished by some mail. The mech, I believe, was right. Oh, yes. He's picked it up now a bit on the Mirana. So they are going to have a mechanism ready for the next fight. By the time the next fight comes around, the Vlads will almost certainly be complete on Universe. So they'll have a couple more auras and reverse as well to help and kind of stick the fights out a little bit longer. But the question really is the damage. Where's it going to come from? And you're looking at RTZ Sven, 1100 now onto the SMY. I mean, does he have to get a BKB this game to be able to do anything in the fights, or do you feel he has to go straight for a damage item?
Well, they have 2 disables that go through BKB, so it doesn't really seem like an amazing choice, but he might need it. Like, that's the problem with Sven in this game, is he might actually need to buy BKB, even though it's not even that good. Best case scenario, he pops BKB, then he gets roared. Or he gets, you know, Winter's Curse, whatever. Either one, he ain't gonna be doing anything for a little while during that BKB duration. But at the same time, if he doesn't have it, then he can get Earth Spirit stunned, he can get Yule's Ice Path, he can get slowed by Splinter Blast. There's just so many things that are annoying on the side of Complexity that he has to worry about, so I think the Blink BKB standard choice.
Smoke up here, they're gonna run straight into it. It's a 3-man Chrono from Universe. Where's the bomb? Here it comes! Man of this Death Ward, and he's coming in with some free will, a beautiful stone. The 3-man Ice Path, Z-Freak Corsair free. He's caught out of the sidelines. They get the stun from Sven, leaping forward on Fear. They'll take down a four. An EG off the back of a brilliant Chrono from Universe. Take a very convincing fight, the most convincing fight we've seen in this game, and they'll get Roshan on top of that.
I mean, that was an insane, insane initiation from Universe. Just catching three heroes immediately, smoke breaks, they're just on them straight away. And even though the Golden Brace coming out from Deepgrip is really nice, the damage had pretty much already been dealt. At that point, you're not going to get the kind of initiation that you want, and I'm pretty sure he didn't even get a chance to cast Roar, because he got stunned in the sphere, went to like 10%, then he got Golden Brace, and then he died. The other thing too that I wanted to point out during that engagement is how good Voodoo Restoration is against Earth Spirit. Because it's all damage over time, right? So you're basically healing 40 damage every second that it's active. And the ability Magnetize at low level, it only hits for about 50, and that's before magic reduction. So honestly, it completely negates the damage. Like, how do you deal any more damage after that fact? You know, like if your Beastmaster is dead, he doesn't roar a target, you don't have any burst, there's no E-Blade up on your team yet. I don't really feel like Complexity can look for the 5 versus 5 when the Witch Doctor is actually this far ahead.
I mean, as you said, the Vita Restoration is a huge issue at this point, and I think down to the point where we might even see, you know, Swindle's just eyeing up the Witch Doctor, getting the Necro units on, so you know, getting rid of that mana, so PPD just can't sit there at the back healing up the team through all these kind of damage over time spells that Complexity have. They need to pretty much shut the Witch Doctor out of it.
This is a good move, though. They're fully understanding that taking the engagement with all the cooldown they have on EG is not a good idea for them.
Spike onto Samael, will be used up, and again, Universe, and the Chrono onto two. But the Golden Brace onto Limb, and now the Deathbot coming through. Chessy's been stunned up, he's starting to morph, and he will get himself out of the replica. But they've already lost two. The Hansken will get the Winter's Curse off, so they do lose Fear, but they're looking to pick up a fourth again, and again it's going to be a team fight where EG take four. This time they do lose one, but again it's getting to the point where EG are coming out on top massively of every team fight. It's all down to Universe's Chrono. I believe that was literally the second it came back off.
Yeah, it came off cooldown as they were pushing. I think City just felt very pressured to try to do something before ultimates were up again. Biggest problem that they're going to have with their lineup is trying to find that timing where Universe doesn't have Sphere and they can try to push and end, because this lineup with a new hero, it's very clear that this hero is not meant to go super late. Like, he can be kind of useful, but as a mid, he's not going to have the same kind of impact as Alina late game. Like, not even close in terms of the least damage output and what he brings to the team. So they need to try to keep pushing, but the problem is, if they can't hit the timing when the Sphere is down and they're losing fights so heavily, they're never making a trade. They're just getting wrecked. If you can't split them up, which their team is very bad at pushing, can't beat them in 5v5, and you still have yet to high ground by like 30-35 minutes, their lineup starts to fall flat. So it's very concerning right now that Complexity have not yet been able to reach the high ground or even kill a 5-3 at this point. And by the way, old Hansen Z-Freak earlier, and I kept thinking that Z-Freak was playing Winter Wyvern because he played the last game.
Talking about Z-Freak, rolling out to Arctor. Lepid's there as well, looking for the perfect angle for the ice path. Who's gonna find it? Caesar's out of there with the war cry and the moonlight shadow from Fear. Be fine, but as you said, Complexity have got quite a hill to climb back up in. EG certainly looking to be in the strongest position, and Universe. Two Chronos set up those two massive fights, and he's now just 100 gold away from having the Blade Dagger, so it's going to be even easier for him to find those openings to really set up the good stuff. Here in the jungle, they found PPD straight up the Witch Doctor. RT's going to look for the TP out, but the stun from Earthspread catches him. PPD does get bored there. We're trying to glimmer and get himself out of that one, so they'll find a kill off the Witch Doctor. Can they get Arctor as well? Limp Zedus up with the Yule Scepter. They're going to slow down onto Arctor. The Paws chopping away at him as well. RTZ trying to fight himself out of this one. So Mayo gets the stun onto Chessy on the sidelines, but they've already lost two AEG. PPD and Arctor are down. Complexity finding some very big clean kills there.
Downside is they're going to find out very shortly that EG has buyback, and the only person they're going to be able to force to buyback is going to be Sven, because the Witch Doctor will most likely be up in time, and Roshan is not even close to being alive, so they just realize, they're like, we can't really do anything with this. We get some picks, we'll take the advantage that we got from that, take our farm, get a little bit of map control, and then just go back to doing what we were doing before. But those kills are nice. It's so long before Chessy's going to be able to really offer a lot. Like, the fact that he went for Yasha, he doesn't have the E-Blade combo, he's not really scary in terms of picking a hero off.
He's racking up the gold now, instead of finishing off the Manta recipe and okay, yeah, so yeah, he's just gonna keep the Yasha Yasha. He is going for Scotty.
He is going for Scotty.
He's picked up the orb.
Yeah, but I mean, he could just go Lincoln's now. Just keep the Yasha casual. I don't know if Scotty's that good. Maybe it's okay against Sven. It might not actually be that bad. I just think that in a lot of games, especially when you don't have a lot of burst on your team, like not having E-Blade, for example, you could kill Sumail with an E-Blade combo. That's a big deal, like being able to burst him down, being able to burst down the Witch Doctor before Glimmer Cape comes out. Like, this Scotty choice is very bizarre. Don't see this too often.
There's Twindles here. Bots before Blink. What do you think? Why so this game?
Well, I think in this scenario, they know that the game might devolve into split pushing in order for them to be able to win.
Oh, EG closing in. The smoke will be dispelled. They know that they're up there. Moonlight Shadow. It's going to allow EG to maybe close the gap before Universe. Was Blink in? Maybe seeing if you can find a Chrono out here. Complexity still hanging around. There's a level 3 Necros giving them the vision. Force PPD back and EG on the retreat back to the base here. Chetsy has got a haste. He's not going to go too close to that though. Want to run the risk of being chronoed and taken down. It's getting some more, one of those points in the game where very, very tense between the two sides. Looking towards Rosh, still a fair few minutes, but it is back. EG coming out again a bit more. Complexity are still over their side of the map. Poor, taking a bit of burn there from the Necro units.
They are indeed painful. Necro being down, Seer being up, this is actually an opportunity for EG to take a team fight. All they really have to do is wait for PPD to heal up.
And fail on Limp, ready for the next one. And you already talked about this earlier, how much magic damage it does. And here's the setup on the mid lane. They're going to try and bring down Chessy. He begins to morph. He's been stuck in the corner, but this man with the Scotty, incredibly hard to kill. Not hard enough, though. Sumail finishes off the deal there with the Laguna. But we saw just there with the Scotty how long it takes them to kill this Morphling.
Yeah.
But they do kill it. He's down for 45 seconds, and this man does not have buyback.
The other thing too is you could very easily make the argument that no item saves him from that. He had E-Blade, he'd still die. If he had Scotty, he'd still die. If he had Manta, he would still die. There's just nothing that saves you from that amount of hate, unfortunately for him, so. City definitely on the back foot here. They have a couple of ways to maybe take a team fight. High ground defense they have is pretty decent. They have good wave clear. You just talked about the Veil pickup as well. Swindle potentially looking for a off here.
Oh, Swindles. I'm sure, but yeah, he's fine. He's got the bots. They're still on cooldown though for a bit of time, aren't they? 30 seconds. So he needs to be careful. He doesn't reveal himself because this could be a little bit of a suicide mission.
Could actually kill Sumail if he roars him, if PPD is not too close. But I don't think he will.
That's the only way. Now he's going to have the vision with the hawk.
Okay. Spooky.
Stay calm, Swindles. Don't breathe.
He's not going to move.
He's moving!
He's
going!
He
wants to do it! With the Necro units, he might get! It looks like the casting should have been up for the Glimmer Cape. Swindles, he'll be able to get himself out as well. He's got the rest of the team around. EG trying to initiate on the most of them in the mid lane, and well, somehow, again. TZ as well, he's still sticking about here. Taking an adaptive strike to the face. Cars going for a universe, he's going to look for the open for a Chrono. Still 15 seconds though before it's going to be available. Let's see, on the Scotty, onto Universe. Yeah, now the rest of EG retreating. And one of those fights just a little bit messy. Neither team able to find the opening. Universe just unfortunately didn't have that Chronosphere back off cooldown. He's going to have it now. Complexity, I think they're realizing that. They're not sticking around for this one.
Why did they ult there? I was so confused. Why did they Moonlight Shadow? Were they just trying to go warp?
Did they just expect Complexity to come further down?
I guess they are kind of lacking vision right now. Maybe they were anticipating a team fight happening there, but yeah, definitely not gonna be the case. But EG will be probably fine with it either way. Getting the LT isn't a huge deal. It's not that long of a cooldown. Actually, at level 1, it is quite long. I thought he might have a little bit, but it's a little over 2 minutes. Now they're waiting for Roshan, which is going to be up in about a minute and a half, 2 minutes.
I mean, when it comes to contesting Rosh, do you think is there a clear winner?
Oh, EG's like really good.
The whole shebang.
Yeah, I mean, they have Blink initiation from Sumail. He's level 16, he's making his way towards Aghanim's. Doing the burst is completely insane. That's kind of what Complexity are lacking, right? They don't have that bursty hero that just takes somebody out of the fight straight away, which I really think they need, and why I was kind of confused to see that Chessy decided to go for Scotty instead of for E-Blade or, you know, Lincoln's E-Blade, whatever normal build you want to do. Going for casual Helm of the Dominator or casual Yasha is pretty common on Morph, because the hero needs he needs the mobility from Yasha because he's very slow. But having the Dominator allows you to sustain in the jungle without having to use Waveform, which is a big deal because Morph is pretty mana dependent when it comes to team fights. But you have to go for something a little bit different here. It does make him super tanky though. That's the one thing about it that's nice. However, I don't think tankiness is the issue for complexity. I think it's just they don't have any damage.
Still, a lot of attention being put around this pit. It's now under a minute before Roshan is back up. Universe moving into the jungle. There is a fair few members of complexity there, four at the moment. This is fine. They don't have any vision here in the jungle on the side of complexity. EG got a bit of ward control around the Rosh pit. Complexity has still got that ward rocking around the Ancients, so they know the EG are sitting around. Still a lot of things coming out. Both teams, it looks like neither of them willing to make the first jump, at least until Roshan is back up, and he is now up. So this could be the build-up to a very, very key fight in this game.
Yeah, this is the breakout fight.
Yeah.
For sure.
The Moonlight Shadow going to lead in, but the Wyvern did pick up a gem. Now I'm going to be ready for this one. This is going to be illusion here. The Winter's Curse will be able to zoom out. They'll get the crew they wanted to. Ice Bomb holding Melina back. There's the roar onto PVD, but PVD kept alive there by Fierce Mech. He'll be able to warn us over the Glimmer Camp. The Voodoo Restoration keeping him alive. But no, it still goes down. That was the first death of the fight. Jesse's still fighting up. RT's getting caught out by the stun. Light Strike Laguna onto Limb. Has another burst of strike. That's double on top. Whoa! The hits from Sven. Chopping through Complexity is a double kill. Has to deliver the TV out. He's going to make it a bash. The Light Strike. Triple kill for RT's. As they clean up house, and EG again wiping the floor with Complexity.
That was such a bad turnaround for Complexity. Like at the start of the fight, Artor pops B, runs in. The Morph like goes into the Chronosphere with Artor, and Universe hits him with it as well. So all of a sudden, Artor's got like BKB on, stuck in the Chronosphere. He's like, alright, well, this isn't necessarily the most fun thing I've ever experienced, but the Focus Fire coming out from Complexity, they had to go for a support because the other heroes are just too far away. Like, they can't kill Artor with BKB on. He's got 2400 health and 43 armor. This is what I was talking about. They just don't have any way of killing this man. You're not going to kill Sven with Magnetize and Jakiro damage when you have Voodoo Restoration and he's got BKB. He's also just purchased a full Assault Cuirass on top of that, so he's going to go kill Roshan.
Oh, it's easy. 17,500 net worth here, 5,000 above Morphling. And even more now for this Roshan and the Eyes. And as we can see, the overall difference between the teams, over 15,000 now, the lead for EG. The question is, can Complexity do anything about this Roshan? I think they're going to be able to get there quick enough. As we talked about with the AC, make sure what if they are. Running to make movements over there. It's not going to be quick enough. EG should be able to get this. They're getting closer and closer. They're still trying to kick off a fight. Jesse on the front lines. Limp as well, setting something up with the Yule Scepter. Looking for Artis, but Artis gets the BKB off in time. He gets the stun onto Limp. Now he turns towards Jesse. Looking to try and bring down the Warping. Warping walks away. Now the Devil just let down. Limp, he's been corner braced up. He's going to be fine. He's down in the corner of the universe. Catching Twiddles in Jesse. Laguna, they're trying to bring down this Warping. They want to kill him. And they will. That's going to be the Warping down. Warping dead. Stun from Artis to 2. Slashes through him. It's a nice stun for Sifri, but it doesn't matter. They've already lost 3 on the side of Complexity. Now the rest of them are going to get themselves out. Blink Force and Sim out. Trying to catch the Earth Spirit, gets the Lion Strike. Now with the Dragon Slayer, the right clicks as well. Zafreak turns around, the stun, the silence, but Fear's there, helping out Samel. They'll chase down Zafreak, the arrow's gonna miss, but they use him up, they buy the time. Light Strike down onto the Earth Man, and he is dead. Four falling on Complexity, and again, it's 23-8. EG, just they've stepped up the level of play across the series. Game one was tough for them. Game two, they really came back into it, and now again in game three, EG just destroying Complexity at this point.
I really feel like Complexity's draft is... At first I thought it was okay, but the more I watch the game, the more I'm starting to realize that the Morphling timing just doesn't synergize with the rest of their team at all. Jakiro, Winter Wyvern, Earth Spirit, Beastmaster, all these heroes need to be able to apply pressure and kind of dictate the pace of the game for the first 20 to 25 minutes minimum. And then you have Morphling, who doesn't really come online until after that point. So maybe they were going with the idea that they could just get the Morphling to farm and hopefully be able to carry the game off. I mean, it just doesn't matter, dude. This ace, he doesn't care.
Correct.
Yeah. This lineup of Complexity had to play a very fast-paced game in order to win against the core of AG, and they just couldn't hit the timing.
This AGG.
They definitely didn't. I was like, wait a minute, did I miss this thing?
Can we not have a thank GG from production, please? I think that's a bit the end. Anyway, Universe gets the Chrono out. They'll probably out for as well. They'll stun up Z-Freak. They do get the Winter's Curse off. And now the Laguna also lives. They're trying to move himself forward, but he is dead. RTZ starting to clean up house. 2-4 on the side of Complexity. There's your GG. Well played. And spoilers, please.
Well, we had a 322, we might as well have had a fake GG, right?
I guess so.
Now the series ended and they know this, so the series is complete.
I don't know what's going on, but anyway, EG, they certainly turn up on the end. Yeah, now you can show up.
Alright. But no, I really do think that the tempo of Complexity's lineup didn't quite mesh up to what it needed to be. I think picking the middle lane Jakiro in conjunction with the Morphling was the problem. Maybe picking something like a Lycan or, you know, even a Drow, something that could actually allow you to push, or Luna, just